So I worked at Apple. I've been a venture capitalist, an entrepreneur, an advisor to Google. I've done a lot of things, and I've learned a lot about innovation, which I would like to pass on to you now so that you may go and change the world. Okay? This is my top 10 of the art of innovation. It starts with the desire to make meaning as opposed to make money. Making meaning means that you change the world. And I think you'll notice that if you happen to change the world, you will also probably make money. But if you start off with the sole desire to make money, you probably won't make money, you won't make meaning, you won't change the world, and you will probably fail. So my first thought for you is determine how you can make meaning. How can you change the world? Here are some examples. With Apple, Apple wanted to democratize computers. They wanted to bring computing power to everyone. That's the meaning they made. With Google, they wanted to democratize information, making information available to everyone. With eBay, they wanted to democratize commerce so that anyone with a website could stand toe-to-toe with any other large retailer. Examples of companies making meaning, and YouTube finally wanted to enable people to create video, to upload video, to share video. So this is an example of the company and the kind of meaning they made. And as you know, they all made this kind of meaning, and they've been highly successful. So what I noticed in my career is that if you truly want to make meaning, it's the first step towards innovation. The second step is to make a mantra, a two or three, maybe four-word explanation of why your meaning should exist. This is an anti-example. This is the mission statement of Wendy's. The mission of Wendy's is to deliver superior quality products and services for our customers and communities through leadership, innovation, and partnerships. I have been through Wendy's many times in my life. I've eaten at Wendy's, I've driven through Wendy's, and in every occasion, it has never occurred to me that, Guy, what you are participating in is leadership, innovation, and partnerships. You know, excuse me, but I thought I was just getting French fries, Coke, and a hamburger. This is the problem with mission statements. Don't make a mission statement. Make a mantra. Wendy's mantra should be healthy, fast food. Three words that determine what Wendy's is trying to do. Somewhat oxymoronic, but healthy, fast food. Nike. Nike has a great slogan, "Just Do It." That's a slogan. A mantra explains why you should exist. And the Nike mantra is authentic athletic performance. And finally, there's FedEx. When you absolutely, positively want something somewhere, what does FedEx stand for? It stands for peace of mind. So my second recommendation to you is that when you decide on the kind of meaning you make, try to find two or three words that describe why that meaning should exist. Not a 50-word mission statement, two or three-word mantra.